Now we are on to the Democratic nomination, and it is a wide open race. The front runners, Dennis Kucinich, who is backed by Bernie Sanders and his wing of the Democratic Party, and the man who joins us now, Richard Cordray, who has the endorsement of Senator Elizabeth Warren. Nice to see you, sir. Appreciate you being here with us. Does this represent the split in the Democrat Party right now between Bernie Sanders and the Elizabeth Warren wing, or are they really the same wing, and then you've got Ohio Democrats?
No, I don't think it represents any real split in the party. Bernie Sanders has not made an endorsement in this race, although Senator Warren has endorsed me. And I think what you see is...
I think we should have said the Bernie Sanders wing of that.
Yes, although he's said he's not endorsing in Ohio this year. Look, what we're doing is we're presenting a case to the voters of Ohio. In our case, Betty Sutton and I are running on what we call the kitchen table issues that people talk to us about all over the state, that things that worry them at night, worry them in terms of looking out for their families, includes access to affordable health care, better education and training for their children, and also spreading out economic opportunity across the state so nobody's left out or left behind.
Where do you have to be in a state that President Trump won by 8 points to win back the governor's mansion? You've got an A rating from the NRA, and at the same time, you're trying in a primary to go after voters who are far left of an A rating from the NRA on the issues.
So in my case, what I try to do in a campaign is talk about what I would do in the office and make promises that I can keep and promises that people care about making sure we deliver on. So in our case, it is focusing on those kitchen table issues and letting people understand
what are kitchen table issues? What can you deliver on that needs change?
So again, these are the economic issues that dominate people's lives.
But when I'm in Ohio, people tell me that the economy here is booming. You go to Columbus, where you're from, and there is construction everywhere.
So people are worried about their health care, and there's a whole circus going on in Washington right now as to what's happening with health care. People worry about the fact that they could be diagnosed with a condition tomorrow, and do they have access to affordable health care for themselves and their children? That's a big issue for people. Education and training, everybody understands that that's the key to the future. And we have an education system here in Ohio where for-profit charter school experiment has devastated many of our schools, taking tons of money out of the public and parochial schools and putting it into failing online schools that have now made off with $80 million that's missing that we'll never see again.
All right, let's now get to the politics of this race. Dennis Kucinich, the former mayor of Cleveland, is running against you. He has had time inside politics, time outside politics. He was on Shannon Bream's show last night. Take a listen.
One of the main criticisms they have of you is that you have spent so much time here with us on Fox News. Here's your primary challenger, Richard Cordray, talking about that.
He knows the game he was playing. He's brought on so that they can say that they're fair and balanced. He's their house poodle. That's exactly what it was. He played the game. He took their money. He made his choices.
House poodle, your response.
Your response to the response.
Look, I think I stated it for what it was. Everybody makes choices in life. When I was standing up for consumers and fighting to see that they're treated fairly, he was a paid commenter on Fox News.
Noteworthy, you're on Fox News right now. We appreciate you being here, but is somebody giving their opinion and defending their ideals, which he did many times on our show? Is that something to knock him for? I'm unclear what the attack is.
He said one thing on Fox News and parroted a line there and said very different things in this campaign. So in terms, depending on who he was paid by.
What did he say either on Fox News or other places that you have issues with that you feel he's being disingenuous about now?
He praised Donald Trump's inaugural speech and then tried to scrub his Twitter feed so that that wouldn't be known to Ohioans. He gave speeches to CPAC conference and then whited that out when he put it up on his Facebook post. He's trying to obliterate his past, but people know it. You can't, the internet doesn't work that way. And in fact, when he was paid to do things, he took a different line than he has taken in the campaign. So people don't like it when people say one thing in one setting and another thing in another setting. I think it's, not a good thing.
Well, there was a time that hypocrisy was seen as a bad thing in Washington. Sometimes we wonder now, perhaps in Ohio, it's still seen in a negative light. We appreciate you being here, sir. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Good to have you.